This one is actually, I believe, a 4-bedroom, 3-bath, 2,800 square feet. The living room, kitchen, and dining room are on one side of the house, and the bedrooms and bathrooms are on the other side of the house. They're asking $750. The comp that's same size as this house, pending at $1 million.
It's a good comp.
They told me that there is mold.
Okay.
So the extent of the mold, I don't know, but pretty much they want an answer today.
It has mold, and they want an answer today. Looks like Tarek wants to buy it.
Most investors would be really scared to buy this house because of the mold. But in flipping, the higher the risk, the higher the reward.
Nice area.
So busy.
Yeah, nice area, but there's mold in here.
What?
Yeah.
Too good to be true.
All right. Ooh, stinky.
Ugh. Any chance you have, like, some masks?
I do.
It's definitely not healthy to be breathing. This might not be the best buy. I really don't know why you had me rush over here so fast.
Relax, I don't know why you're so cranky today. Chill.
I'm in a fabulous mood.
I don't know why you're so aggressive towards me.
Not aggressive, I was just making a comment.
Honestly, I'm not sure what's happening with Christina, but for business, she needs to snap out of it soon.
It's pretty bad, guys, so.
All right, let's go.
Oh.
So clearly there's mold damage right here.
Yeah.
Oh, wow. That's like mold.
Ew.
Yeah, that's a problem. I mean, the layout's good. You walk into a nice room.
Kind of. It's kind of closed off, though.
Look at this. More.
Ooh.
This is probably the worst we've seen.
It's all over the house.
Ew.
That's not good.
Mold like this isn't only a huge problem, it's really unsafe. So if we get this house, we're gonna have to hire a professional mold company to come in and let us know how bad it is. Normally, I would do this before making an offer, but if we want this house, we have to act today.
Kitchen's really, really teeny tiny for this size house. It's really awkward.
Terrible.
Yeah.
And we definitely have to expand it. What do you think we're even looking at to do a kitchen that probably goes out to, like, at least where these cabinets are, you know?
You're looking at about 18 to 20 grand for this.
Okay, that's not too bad.
All right, let's keep looking.
There's a massive fireplace. We'd have to do something there. We're looking at, like, what, 3 grand?
For sure. Wow, this is bad.
It is bad, and you know what? This is kind of funky.
Why are there rocks in the corner?
In here, I mean, we'd probably have to close up this window and just make something spectacular.
Yes,
we have
sir.
To if we're trying to get to the top of the comps.
What are you thinking in there, like 15,000?
Yeah.
This house has good flow. I mean, it really does. I mean, it's just a horrific mold problem.
Considering the mold situation, which we don't know the cost of yet, we offered $725,000, but the seller wouldn't budge. So Tarek pushed for a full price offer at $750,000. I hope the cost of the inspection and the mold remediation don't sink us.
Good news, bad news, what do we have today?
I think it's all bad.
Huh?
Not only do you have mold, but they discovered that your house has asbestos.
What?
How much more expensive?
For the mold and asbestos, it's $20,000.
Wait, are you kidding right now?
No, I wish I was, huh?
That's a fortune.
Yeah.
All right, so bottom line is this. We have to get rid of the mold, we have to get rid of the asbestos. I mean, we're totally, totally getting screwed here. At the same time, we can't sell an unsafe house, so. All right.
The kitchen absolutely cannot stay like this.
I think we just open this up to the window,
yep.
Pop in a new header.
Totally agree.
How much would a new header be?
$1,500.
So what if we just made a monster kitchen and ran countertop all the way, this wall's gone, and we run it all the way out, maybe right here?
Love it. It'll give me a huge kitchen to design. Tarek pushed to buy this house, and we spent a lot of money fixing things that buyers will never see. He's gonna have to follow my lead on design if we wanna maximize our profits.
We've been looking for the source of all that mold, and we're actually lucky that it rained. Now we could see that the mold was caused by water intrusion from the concrete patio sloping towards the house.
We have to remove all this concrete, not just here, but on the backside.
Yeah, it's a total disaster. You gotta tear this thing out.
All new concrete. Remove patio, we're talking about, that's almost 3 grand.
That's a big hit. But it's lucky that we caught it now, so we could fix it before any new mold grows here.
That's now $23,000 in repairs that we've spent on the mold issues.
And the kitchen looks double the size. I brought two flooring options, a wood look and a gray.
Mm-hmm. I don't like this floor. I really like this floor.
I like that floor too, but now that I see it in the room, I just think it's gonna be too much gray. What about this flooring do you not like?
It has a lot of yellow in it. Let me put it next to the cabinet.
Oh, beautiful. Ding, ding, ding. Winna, winna, winna. This one is definitely the way to go, but Tarek is fighting me on it. What this is really all about is that he wants the decision to be his, just like buying this moldy house.
I mean, it's not my favorite, but it works now that it's on the floor next to the cabinet. Why don't we do just a straight white quartz counter?
Mm-mm.
Oh, what do you mean?
No, I like the look of the marble with this. Really pretty.
Marble's going out.
Says who?
Everybody.
Oh my god.
I know you're behind the trend.
We haven't searched the internet lately. All right, all right. We all know that marble's not out, but she's just on my last nerve.
So he thinks I just get my ideas from a website? No, I work hard to figure out which looks go with each house. If he wants to get back any of the money that we spent on this nightmare of a project, he's gonna have to trust me. Hey, boys.
Hey.
Hey.
It's like really industrial.
It looks great. I love the smooth plaster.
It doesn't even match the kitchen at all. It's a totally different look.
You're just saying that to be annoying.
I'm just literally so tired of it.
You're tired of it?
Yeah.
No, I'm tired.
I'm tired of it. Oh my God. I'm sorry. I like the geometric fireplace design. I just don't like that dark wood.
Let's compromise at least, so we're not fighting anymore.
Good.
Why don't we paint these white instead of wood?
I think this painted white would make a huge difference. I think that would look really nice.
How much would that be?
$800.
Okay. Much easier without fighting.
Thank you. It looks really nice. I like the paint color. The new windows look a lot better, too.
Oh, my gosh. Thank God we put the new windows in. They were expensive, though. Actually, we got killed here. We had the mold and the asbestos and then, oh, the patio thing in the back.
Plus all the expensive upgrades.
Oh, can't forget about that. After everything, with all the problems we had, we spent $130,000.
Ouch.
Ouch is right. So that's $880,000. We're gonna have $30,000 in selling costs. Our break even is gonna be $910,000.
Ooh. Pretty, I love the floors.
It actually looks really good.
Kind of farmhouse chic.
You know what? Look how nice this is.
The kitchen looks insane. It looks huge.
You can see the view now.
Wow, you really can.
This right here is what's gonna sell the house. Love the waterfall edge.
Yes, and the marble looks amazing. My favorite part is actually the backsplash. It is beautiful.
It all tied in really, really well. So I know that we had some issues with the fireplace. Now that it's done, I think it looks very nice.
Painting it white, huge difference. It blends in nicely with the kitchen now, has a nice modern look, it looks really pretty.
This house is spectacular. I would say the biggest transformation has gotta be the master bathroom.
The shower's massive. I feel like it's the biggest shower we've ever done. Well, the fact that we did the rain head and the other shower head, I mean, killed it.
We did the opening, we added the barnyard doors for privacy.
Yeah, and the good thing is it saved a lot of space.
It's a good sized bedroom.
Nice sized bedroom. It's nice that it opens to the backyard.
Yeah, and at night you still have a view.
Yeah. Bathroom number two. This one's pretty. It's a great guest bathroom. The tile plays off the floor really nicely.
Yeah.
Despite the mold issues, we ended up going all out on this flip.
Look at this. You can see the mountains.
We think the house looks awesome, and all the people that came through the open house loved it. After a few weeks on the market, we ended up accepting an offer at $1,030,000. If this deal goes through, after closing costs, we stand to make a profit of about $120,000.